Hello everyone, today we will be continuing with the covalent bond. Previous day we had a discussion on electrovalent bond formation. We have seen orbital picture diagram. Today we will be doing covalent bond. I hope you all are practicing the electron valent bond diagram. Basically, Lewis dot structure is very easy to draw. In Lewis dot structure, what we do, we just draw the number of valence electron, one with dot, another with cross, and then we show the formation. But in case of orbital picture diagram, you need to draw all the shells and then you need to show. It's better if you use compass, that looks good in the paper. Freehand drawing is also allowed, but better if you draw with the compass, and you can use pencil and pen both. Now, covalent bonds, last day we have discussion on electrovalent bond. Electrovalent bond, in electrovalent bond, they have strong electrostatic force of attraction among them. The bonds are held by only iron, so they have very strong force. But in case of covalent bond, basically the molecules, inside a molecule there is a sharing of electrons. So molecules here are holding themselves with a very weak van der Waals force of attraction. In an ionic bond, in a lattice of an ionic compound, there are number of ions which are present, and they themselves are attracting with a very strong force, and their perfect molecule does not exist. Like in case of sodium chloride, one sodium is surrounded by six other chloride ion, and one chloride is surrounded by another six sodium ion. So particularly one molecule, that discrete molecules that is present in case of covalent compounds like N2O2 H2, in this way does not exist in case of ionic compounds. So as they are in a cluster, suppose so many ions are floating, so that their attraction being very strong, these ionic compounds are generally solid at room temperature. And in case of covalent compounds, our covalent molecules, suppose oxygen, so nitrogen, the molecules which are present, and then they are attracting themselves, but their attraction, force of attraction is much weaker because no ion is generating there, and we call it weak van der Waals force of attraction. The van der Waals force of attraction is basically weak here. And in case of water molecules, suppose water molecule is water is liquid. In case of water, the molecules are held by a particular bond known as hydrogen bonds, which below 0 degree centigrade makes it to freeze, and then 0 to 100 degree centigrade liquid, and the above 100 degree centigrade it turns to gas. So in case of water molecule, the intermolecular force of attraction is bit stronger than that of nitrogen and oxygen. That's why we find in the room temperature nitrogen, oxygen, they are in the gaseous state, whereas water is in the liquid state. So depending on the molecules, depending on the basic unit which is present inside of a particular substance, the outside the state depends, whether it will be solid, whether it will be liquid, or it will be gas. That depends on the internal force of attraction, which is basically depending on the bonds in them. So chemical bonds plays a very vital role, an important role to its outside appearance, that is whether it will be solid, whether it will be gas, or it is a liquid. So in case of covalent compounds, always there are sharing of electrons. I will be just showing you how this is shown basically in an orbital picture. Actually, electrons, you cannot count in the real life electron as 1, 2, 3, 4. Like you cannot see the atoms in through a microscope or ultra resolution microscope, and you cannot count, see there's one electron, two electron. It cannot be seen in that. It stays in form of clouds. Now the atoms picture is already out. You all can see how it looks like. It's already available in the internet. So you will find it's like a cloud formation. So when there is sharing of electron, that is basically the overlapping of that electron clouds. So when there is equal overlap of the electron cloud, then if suppose two same atom is present, the cloud overlapping is equal, then the distribution of the electron cloud is same. But when their overlapping is not similar, that means one atom has a little bit of higher tendency to attract the cloud towards itself a little more, like a tug of war competition, where one is a little bit more powerful, then the cloud get shifted a bit. So this shifting of the clouds makes the molecule polar. This concept of polar and non-polar we discussed in water chapter. I had a full video on this about polar and non-polar. You all let me know if I repeat that polar non-polar part once again. So covalent compounds can be of polar covalent compounds and non-polar covalent compounds. Water is polar, but oxygen, nitrogen, they are non-polar. So when there is a polar covalent molecules, then the intermolecular attraction is bit higher. When there is a non-polar covalent compound, then intermolecular attraction is bit lesser. That actually makes it gaseous or liquid. That will be our deciding factor. So now I am showing you how to draw the orbital picture diagram for different covalent molecules. You keep practicing this, and next day I think we can end this chapter here. We can discuss certain question answer from this chapter, and then we can start another interesting chapter, periodic table. In periodic table, this time we have mainly history of periodic table. That is, you need to read little bit of history of chemistry here. Application part of the periodic table, that is periodicity of the elements, different properties of the element depending on the periodic table, those are there in class 10 first chapter. Here we have idea of the making of periodic table, the story behind the making of periodic table. Anyway, we'll go to that chapter later on. Let us see today the orbital picture diagram of the covalent molecules. So last day we have drawn all this, and today we will be seeing the covalent bond formation. If we start with hydrogen, the easiest one, nucleus and one electron in the outside. Here also nucleus and one electron in the outside. Then there is sharing of electron, and then this formation of hydrogen one atom. So suppose next we need to show the oxygen. Oxygen 2,6, so two shells, nucleus, there also two shells and nucleus. So here you need to draw the two electron, here you need to draw 4, 5, 6 electron, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 electron, and then here two electron, and then sharing of electron in this way. So there is double covalent bond, here you have single covalent bond, here about double covalent bond. If it is nitrogen, nitrogen has electronic configuration 2,5, so it needs 3 electrons to complete its valence shell. So it will share 3 electrons, so it will have a triple covalent bond. Now triple means at a time 3 bonds, along with that 2 electron will be unshared, we call it lone pair of electron. In case of water, water H2O, so you can do one thing, you can draw the oxygen atom at the center. And then this side you can draw the hydrogen, and this side also you can draw the hydrogen. Then here electron, they will share. Here electron, they will share. Now oxygen has, water has 4 more electron extra inside. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oxygen has here only 2 electron. What I am drawing, this is nucleus, 1 and 2 electron, rest all nothing. This is a problem, you know, holding with that. Holding the camera in another hand and then drawing. I cannot see the paper. I am watching this everything through the camera. Now, this is nucleus. This is oxygen atom basically. So, nucleus of oxygen atom. So, this 2 electron which remain unshared, this 2 electron which remain unshared, we call it lone pair of electrons. You will find that every atom here has completed either its octet or its duplet. Like oxygen has outside 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 electron after sharing. Now it has 8 electron. Hydrogen has 1 electron at its valence shell and then 2 electrons. So in this way, nitrogen, ammonia also. So here 2 single covalent bond, here double bond. In ammonia, if you find, ammonia has 3 single covalent bond, and here it is 3 triple bond. So this is the difference between triple bond and 3 single covalent bond, double bond and 2 single covalent bond. So that's about how you draw covalent molecules to orbital picture diagram. These are polar molecules, these are non-polar molecules. Because it is similar atom, this is dissimilar atom. That's about today, and I hope you all are going through the books to see this diagram. I'm also providing you the picture so you can see it nicely. Keep revising, keep drawing nicely, take care, and bye.